Presence of our mama. Let's appreciate our mama. Amen. 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 I thank God so much because also of the leadership of the youth. And I give God all the glory because of this day. When I see first hand.
Amen.
She called me Mama Said. I'm blessed with three boys. And I thank God because of blessing me with the family. I'm blessed with a very handsome man who is my husband. Amen. Hallelujah. And so today I thank God because of also honoring me. My husband came together with me. He told me if I'm going to minister to the youth, he's coming together with me. Thank God. So I thank God so much. It's such a great honor, sweetheart, because of coming together with us today. And I want to give you this chance to say hi to us and greet the youth. Amen. Come on, let's appreciate you.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
I'm so happy to be back home. Several years ago, I used to be an interpreter to Bishop. I used to stand on this side. And I am very happy to see Mom again, and also to see Bishop, who are with him in the fellowship, and today I'm seeing him again. I'm so grateful, and I thank God for this church. It's our church. It's where we belong. And so, God bless you as we receive the word of God from the woman of God. God bless you.
Thank you so much. Oh, give him a better hand. Appreciate him some more. Amen, amen, amen. We've been married for very few years, only 14 years. And we are still in our honeymoon. By the grace of God. Amen. Amen. I think my name is Carol Nzioka, and I'm blessed. I'm born again. I realize there are some people who minister, but they are not born again. I had a testimony of somebody last week who was made the Christian Union leader in their school because he used to sing very well. He was a choir person in their church, so he had a very nice voice. So when he went to school, they thought he's born again. And they chose him as the senior leader. And he was a leader for some years until he finished school. By the time he was finishing school, he could preach and people could cry. People used to cry. They used to receive the, you know, to be filled with the Holy Spirit. They received Christ. But him, himself, he's the one who was giving us that testimony. He wasn't born again. In fact, he told us, sometimes he used to see people fall and, you know, they are speaking in another language. Then he could walk out, and then what is this? What is happening? So I know it's possible to have some people minister who are not born again. That's why I started by saying, I am born again. I'm washed by the blood of Jesus Christ. Praise God.
Amen. Amen.
So I don't want to take much time. I know we don't have a lot of time. And so I wanted to go straight to the word of God. And when I was asking God what I should share with you, he gave me a word. And my theme today is be a bounce back person. Can you tell somebody, be a bounce back person?
Yeah.
Come on, say it louder. Be a bounce back person.
Yeah.
Like be a person who can bounce back. You know what you mean by bouncing back? You know, bouncing back. When things come this way and they, when, you know, they push you to this side, you know this is where I'm supposed to be, you choose to bounce back. Praise God. Amen. I was reading a story about, I'm not very good in history, but somehow I happened to read this story about a hurricane. I don't know whether they call it hurricane or hurricane, I don't know, depending with your teacher. Me, my teacher taught me it's called hurricane. It's called Hurricane Ike. This particular one happened in Texas, in USA. So when this hurricane happened, it's one of the biggest hurricanes that happened there. How many people know what a hurricane? Before we start talking about things that you don't know. Amen. So it's called Hurricane Ike. And when I was reading the story of Hurricane Ike, I read something very interesting that when this hurricane happened, when it took place, it uprooted even the strongest trees. You know, even those trees which are about 140 feet tall, they all went down because it was digging down from the roots. You know, in Angusha, zile manyumba na miti, you know, it did a lot of damage. And when I was reading that story, something very interesting I noted, that even if it was such a huge, very big kind of a hurricane, there's this one tree that even though it was affected, it still remained. It didn't, like, haikumalizika, haikuisha. And this is a tree that we call a palm tree. Bwana asifiwe sana. There are many trees that fell down. Oak trees, you know how oak trees are very huge, you know. We have all these pine trees. But the palm tree, even if it was bent to almost, you know, like breaking, it bounced back. Praise God. After all that happened, like Aisha, after the hurricane, after that, something interesting is that this tree bounced back. Praise God. And, you know, I was thinking about what is a palm tree. You know, a palm tree is quite skinny. You know a palm tree, right? It's quite skinny and quite flimsy. You know, it looks like it can break at any time. But why was it able to withstand all that kind of, you know, storm, that kind of, you know, the hurricane? Because God created the palm tree to bend, but not to break, even in high wind. Praise God.
Amen.
Even in high wind, the palm tree does not break. God created it such that it cannot break. The palm tree can bend all the way down, until its top touches the ground and still not break. Praise the name of the Lord. Palm tree can be bent over for 4 or 5 hours. Like, it bends down, the head touches down the ground, but it can stay there even for 4 to 5 hours, but still not break. Balasifio. So it's quite, they're quite resilient. And they bounce back after, you know, that challenge. When the challenge comes, it moves with the wind. It's not resistant, like, it's not refusing to go. It will go because it's very thin, it's, you know, it's very flexible. But it will go even touch the ground. It can stay for 4 to 3 or 5 hours down there with the hand down. But after that commotion, after all that challenge, it still bounces back. Praise the Lord. And I want us to read the word of God from the book of Psalms, chapter 92. Can open the word of God from the book of Psalms, chapter 92, and that's where we have been our reading today. Psalms chapter 92, verse 12. I want to read part A. What does the Bible tell us? That the righteous shall flourish like a palm tree. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
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 I say we are reading from the book of Psalms, chapter 92, verse 12a. What does the Bible tell us? Can we read together?
The righteous shall flourish like the palm tree.
Amen. Can you repeat that again?
The righteous shall flourish like a palm tree.
The righteous shall flourish like a palm tree. Praise the Lord. We are the children of God. We are the people that God is speaking about here in this world. That the righteous shall flourish like a palm tree. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
You know that one tells us what? That God, it's not really, I mean, the word palm tree is not mentioned here because it's the, you know, the only thing that came in God's mind when the word was being written. The palm tree is here, it's being mentioned because of such characteristics, as I've told you, and many more that it has. Because scientists say that this palm tree, not scientists, biologists, we call them biologists, eh? they say that the palm tree, during the hurricane, and then when it's being bent down, actually, when it's pushed over, its root system actually strengthens. It strengthens. Yani mizizi yake inapataga nguvu zaidi wakati inapigwa na ule upepo iko karibu kuanguka wakati inasukumwa ndio mizizi yake inapata nguvu zaidi. So by the time that hurricane is ending or the storm is ending, by the time hiyo upepo yenye imepiga sana inakuja kumalizika, hiyo palm tree it bounces back more stronger than it was before. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Isn't that great? That even when we go through challenges in life, that even when things come our way and they push us, you're pushed to the end. You bend to a point of even putting your head down on the ground. The Bible tells us what? That we still bounce back because the righteous man will flourish like a palm tree. So when you're coming back, after what you have gone through, after all the challenges you have been through, by the time you are coming back, God knows that by the time you are coming back, you will be better than you were before. Praise the name of the Lord. And that's how you grow. That's how you grow. We grow from the challenges that we face in life. It helps us to grow. Inatusaidia tunakuwa watu tofauti from who we were before. There's some things that happen to your life just to make you grow, move from one level to another. Praise the name of the Lord. If you're this kind of a person that cry every time when things happen, sometimes God will allow you to really be bent by this hurricane. So that by the time it's finishing with you, by the time he's done with you, you'll be that person that everybody will be looking at and say, oh, surely goodness and mercy has been upon this person. Surely this person can become something that we never thought that he or she could become. Because God says that the righteous man will flourish like palm tree. Praise the name of the Lord. God could have used other trees as an example in this verse, but he chose to use the palm tree. If you think about oak tree is big, it's quite steep. Oak tree, hata huwezi ukaishika hivi. Unaweza izunguka hivi na mtu mwingine ako hapo na huwezi kumshika. You know, especially if it grow ikuwe mature, it is very hard kuwa kwamba unaweza hata ishika around hata kama wewe mkubwa kama mimi. But God did not use that tree as an example. Because during that hurricane, when I was reading that story, I realized even the oak trees, no matter how old they were, no matter how deep-rooted they were, they were all uprooted, and they actually, and you know that the thing that happens until you can't tell mahali kulikuwa na mti, mahali kulikuwa na nyumba, it was such a bad hurricane. So even the oak trees could not withstand that. So God did not use the oak tree here. He used the palm tree. When you think of a tree like the pine tree, it's tall and quite majestic. Yeah, it's able to see. Actually, you can see it. Ukiwa hapa unaweza iona ikiwa mbali. You can tell that is a what? A pine tree. It is quite zinarefukanga hivyo until you can see it from very far. But God did not use that tree because it is not about how tall you are. It is not about how people can see you from far. When it comes to the things of God, God expects us to be like palm trees. Because having a name or, you know, being famous, you know, if you are able to do some things in the church or, you know, outside there, people know that you are this strong person, you can do many things, that's not enough. What God expects us to do is that we be as flexible as the palm tree. Be a flexible person, such that you can be bent and still not break. Most of us, when we are bent, we break even before the breaking time. You know, for example, for those people who, I don't know, we all have different phobia, isn't it? There are those people who imagine, hata kiti imagine akiwa kwa ghorofa juu angalie chini, they can never take down there. Kuna watu wengine, they fear being in water. So ukiingia tu kwa maji, una imagine tu utakufa. So sometimes you die when you are not supposed to die. You know that? You know there are some people who can fall in water and still survive for a longer time than some of us who, the moment you find yourself in water, you say, I die. And you just die. Because it just finishes you. You know? So there are some people, when storms come in their lives, they die before time. They break. They stop serving God and they decide, anyway, if God cannot help me in this, I mean, I cannot serve him. They stop having faith in God. They go back to the world because they are not able to withstand the storms that came in their lives. God expects us to be like that palm tree, that even when things come our way, we can still beg. Praise the name of the Lord. And you know, we can beg still singing, yes, Lord, I know you can. You know, praising in the midst of a storm. The other day we had a challenge. We parked our car somewhere along Zika Road. And when we were trying to put some things inside the car locked itself with the key inside. You know, at Zika Road, kwa bridge. Chini ya bridge. Sasa tumesimama hapo, gari imetrock. We can't move. We can't do anything. The windows are all closed. So nikachukua moto lakini nikakimbia sana nyumbani. You know, our home is not, it's far, but anyway, that day. But then I used to see siwezi enda na motorbike kwa barabara ya lami. That day, hey, even that guy, people thought there's an emergency. I told that guy, he was a Mokorino. I told him, you know what? Hii motorbike unaipeleka mbio. Because inside that car, some of the things that you put in America are my chicken. By the way, I'm a farmer. Sorry, let me make some commercial break. I'm a farmer, I sell eggs and chicken. Sorry for that. Now, my chicken, I had just bought the chicks. Yeah? So many of them, over 100. So we had just put them inside the car. So I imagined how that place is hot. Hey, and I could not wait. Motorbike, pew, mpaka nyumbani. I took the spare key. Tukarudi na huyo mtu wa motorbike. Tukafika fungua ikakataa kufungua. It refused. I don't know what happened because afterwards we realized it was still okay. It could not open. And me, I'm just thinking about my chicken. And I'm imagining now how they will die. Yeah? And I was asking, you know, I was counting the loss. These nice people. I was counting the loss. So I was like, God, you can do something. And at some point, I felt really bad. And I asked myself, why is God allowing this to happen, surely? See, God does miracles. He can do a miracle, he can even find a chicken. See, God does miracles, even greater than that one. So why is God not doing this one? So at some point, I was feeling a bit disappointed. And I was asked, why did I have to go for all those tickets from, you know, I got them from Burana. And then I come here and they die at Thika Road in a car. I wish the car off before we put them in, you know. But at some point, I learned a very big lesson. And I think that's what God was teaching me. At some point, I just went quiet and I started praising God. And I remembered a sermon I had about praising God in the midst of storm. Praise the name of the Lord. And I started singing. I was singing. So as people are passing, they're wondering, what's wrong with me? Because somehow my husband left me and went to look for mechanic. So I'm standing here and people are looking at me, there's this car here. So they're wondering what is happening. And I'm just singing normal. You forgot the word, I'm just singing there. And I'm telling myself, I know my chicken might be dying, but I know I can still praise God in this storm. Praise the name of the Lord. It might look like a very small storm, but I learned a big lesson. Because the moment I started praising God, I started having peace in my heart. And I started feeling, yes, this chicken, they will be safe. None of them will die. It is possible for them to be in the car as hot as it is, but they still survive. Because the miracle I'm expecting, probably that's not a miracle that God wants me to see. Maybe he wants me to see a miracle of having chicken almost an hour in the car, locked inside, and they're in a box, and they still survive. Maybe that is a miracle that God wanted me to learn that day. Praise the name of the Lord. So praising God in the midst of storm, it's very hard. But the moment you start doing it, praise the name of the Lord. You start doing it, you start experiencing a lot of peace in your heart. And you can no longer think about that thing that is bending you down. So even when your head is about to touch down on the ground, keep praising God. Praise the name of the Lord. By the time you are getting out of there, you'll be a stronger person, stronger than you were before. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Let me ask my teacher, are we together? Amen. So, I told you that God used the palm tree in the Bible because He knew there would be difficulties in times, sometimes in our lives, in which we have to bend so we wouldn't break. Praise the name of the Lord. When you are a bounce back person, you will know that when challenges come, it's only temporary. There is no challenge that is permanent. Every challenge, everything you see, one day somebody said something that struck my mind, that everything that you can see with your eyes, anything that your eyes can see, every challenge, everything that you see, you know, with other people, it is temporal. Praise the name of the Lord. There is nothing permanent. So even when you find yourself in a certain kind of a storm, in a certain kind of a situation that is really challenging, it is just a temporal situation. It won't last forever. The Bible says that weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Praise the name of the Lord. That you can suffer, you can go through some stuff today, but after that, there will be joy. Something will happen in your life, and you'll even forget the pain that you went through. You forget that heartbreaking thing that came in your life, and it really bent you down. Something will happen in your life, and it will be morning. Sometimes when you're walking in the dark, you don't imagine, you can't even figure out how it is like when it's daytime. But now when it's daytime, when there is light, sometimes you even forget how it was at night. So when the light comes in your life, that moment when it will be morning, you will actually forget all the things that bent you down, because you actually bounce back. And by the time you're bouncing back, you'll be a stronger person. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. The Bible says from the book of Jeremiah chapter 5, as I finish, Jeremiah chapter 5. Jeremiah chapter 5 verse 22. I'll be finishing in a short while. Hallelujah. 5:22. The Bible says, "For ye, fear ye not me. Fear ye not me?" It's a question mark. Say the Lord. Will ye not tremble at my presence, which have placed the sand for the bound of the sea by a perpetual decree that it cannot pass it? And though the waves thereof toss themselves, yet can they not prevail. Though they roar, yet can they not pass over it. Praise the name of the Lord. I was looking at that word and I was thinking about how, you know, the sand. I was thinking about the sand. Sand itself, when you're not, you know, holding it as a, you know, bunch of it, if you decide to pick it, those particles are very tiny. The particles of the sand, they are very tiny. And you know, God has, you know, sometimes when you look at water, you know, water can be quite violent, eh? It can, you know, water in a more computer, like ukienda mahali kwenye kuna ocean, you see sometimes those waves zinakuja very strongly. And you know what? God has put sand as tiny as it is to make sure that that water does not pass a particular point. Praise the name of the Lord. There's that particular point that that water is not supposed to go beyond. And it doesn't matter how sometimes waves zinakuja. Sometimes zinakuja is kwa na nguvu sana. Zinakuja hata zinapita ni kama zinataka kupita. But after a while, maji inaanza kufanya nini? Kurudi. Kwa sababu kuna ile mpaka ambayo hiyo maji haijaruhusiwa kupita na Mungu. By the way, Mungu ndiye anapangana hiyo kitu. Siku moja nilisimama hali hivi nikajiuliza. Yaani shwari, I was in Mombasa and I was looking at hiyo maji mahali tumesimama. Na hiyo maji yote venye imezunguka hapo. And I was asking myself, you mean hii maji haiwezi kakuja hivi iamue? Ipite tu. Imeze Mombasa yote. Siku anasema it's an island. Ifunike tu hivi because iko all over. But why is it that people have lived there? You know, sometimes when you want to encourage yourself like Jamiaga, Watu wameishi hapa, wakazaliwa, wakakua, wakakufa, wakiwa wazee. Kwa hivyo mimi siwezi nikamezwa. Wewe unapata tukitoka mwaka na kujitia kwa sometimes. Unaingia gari iko na driver very rough. Alafu najiambia kama hii gari ikitoka hata una ikamiki hata si tutafika. Tutafika. Au you know sometimes kuna kabarabara unaweza pitia, unashangaa kama hapo mtatomboa mpaka mwisho. Alafu najiambia hii gari niligoja pale chini ilikuwa imetoka huko. Na mimi nilikuwa nimepanda na ikarudi. So we will still you know that's why we are kujiencourage na kujitia nayo moyo. So sometimes you look at that sand, it may look kama ni kitu kadogo sana, but the Bible says what? That God has put a decree in every grain of sand. Praise the name of the Lord. The decree commands the sand to keep the ocean within the boundaries. The Lord's decree. Praise the name of the Lord. That is the key word. The Lord's what? Decree. It's what causes that sand, that grain of the sand, to hold that water and make sure it doesn't go beyond its boundaries. Praise the name of the Lord. God's decree speaks volume. No matter how tiny the sand grain is compared to ocean, it's still able to hold the waters. Praise the name of the Lord. So when things happen in your life, it doesn't matter how strong they look like they're stronger than you. There is that God's decree in your life. Praise the name of the Lord. There is none of them that itakuja ikumalize. Inaweza ikakupiga, inaweza it can waver you, it can push you from one side to another, but at the end of the day, there's that decree ya Mungu. Praise the name of the Lord. That the righteous shall flourish like palm trees. So you're the righteous one of God. So you will flourish. Even in the midst of that storm, you will still make it. Praise the name of the Lord. What is it that you're going through that is making you feel like you're about to give up? Is it sickness? Do you know that people who are, when they feel sick, kadawa tu, they start feeling now like I'm going. There are people with terminal illness and you know they have felt now it's the end of the world. There are people with financial challenges. Is it a job that you have looked for all your years? You finished your college, you have done everything that anybody is supposed to do as a human being. You have done the tamaki, you are not just seated, but this job is not coming forth. Are you believing God for a wife or a husband? Are you believing God for financial breakthrough? Are you believing God for family matters? There's some challenges that are happening, things that are happening in your family, and you feel like you really want God to come through. What is that thing? What is that hurricane in your life? What is that thing that is making you feel like you're about to give up? I want to remind you today that be a bounce back person. Praise the name of the Lord. That when you get into that situation, that when things turn against what you expected, still stand strong in the Lord and remember the word of God, the decree of the Lord upon your life. And remember what the Bible says. Remember everyone. Be the person that reminds yourself about the word of God. You know, meditate in the word of God when you're in situations that are, you know, when situation is speaking otherwise, speak what God says about that this. Praise the name of the Lord. If you feel like you're about to die, remind the devil you're not dying. You will live. Praise the name of the Lord. When you feel like things are not working in your life, remind the devil, speak to that situation. And tell that situation, it doesn't matter. And I say it doesn't matter, and I'm still begging you. I will still come back. Praise the name of the Lord. When we finish too, like I'm still coming back. And by the time I'm coming back, I'll be stronger. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. You'll go read for yourself from the book of Isaiah chapter 59 verse 19. The Bible tells us, I'll just quote, that when the enemy shall come like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord shall lift up a standard against him. Praise the name of the Lord. That when things come your way, when the enemy comes, you know, when there are things that you're fighting, when the enemy comes your way like a flood, you still stand strong because the Spirit of the Lord shall lift a standard against him. Shouldn't you hear? The Spirit of the Lord will lift you. Praise the name of the Lord. A standard will be raised. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's stand up. May we stand up as we close. Thank you so much, and I believe that you're going to be that bounce back person. Amen. I want to sing this song as I finish. I want to hand over the mic to the leader of the meeting. Where is she? Yeah. As I hand over the mic, I'd like us to sing this song. Uninyunyizie maji wakati wa ukame. Hallelujah. Inua mikono yako uambie Mungu akusaidie in your situation, and tell God that even in this situation, help me to be a bounce back person. I will not die, I will live to see the goodness of the Lord. I will eat the good of the land. It is my promise in the name of the Lord. I will not live all my life suffering. I will eat the good of the land. That's what the Bible tells us. So you don't have to live like you're begging in this world. There's a promise for you in the name of the Lord.